let us keep in mind that we serve you and your people. Help us to see clearly your will and to always strive to be in line with goodness. Though we may fail at times, give us strength to continue on. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have an absolutely fantastic morning plan for you guys. We've got two keynote speakers today, two of our candidates for Forsyth County Commission. Commissioner Todd Levent will be speaking today, and candidate David Hole will be speaking today, and we're looking forward to that. Before we get to their speeches, obviously, though, we'd like to give everybody an opportunity to welcome some of our guests. I see the room is chock full of elected officials and candidates. So here's what I'm going to do. As I go through, if you're both, I'm going to do the candidates first. If you're both a candidate and an elected official and you'd like to say something at that point in time, that's fantastic. Then I'll go back through and I'll give anybody who's a candidate just an opportunity to stand up and say hello as well. So we're looking forward to talking to everybody here today. And if I miss someone, just let me know. Kick me. I miss people all the time. I see Mark Hamilton, representative. Good morning, Mark.
Good morning. Mark Hamilton, the state representative, District 24, currently serving in my fourth term. We've got another week under the Gold Dome before we sign and die. Still have a number of important issues to take up. I've got two very important issues in the Senate right now. One dealing with the dismantling, unfortunately, based on a liberal lawsuit, prohibiting the dismantling of our misdemeanor probation system across Georgia. Could have a negative impact of about $150 million to our local communities. And I'm also carrying a very controversial red meat bill on unemployment, closing a loophole that people are taking advantage of. Could have a impact of about $90 million to our unemployment trust fund. So a lot of controversy, and can pretty much guarantee those will be Republican-Democrat votes, and we'll probably have several hours of debate on those. So it's an honor to serve you and to take on these type of effective conservative challenges that we have down there under the Gold Dome. And I continue to look forward to your support. We'll continue to work for the citizens of the Georgia and represent the 24th district, and I would appreciate your continued support as we do that in this campaign. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
As I zigzag across the room looking for elected officials, I see Pete. Commissioner Pete, stand up.
Good morning, everyone. Glad to be here. Thank you for everything. And I have no opposition this year, so it just feels great.
I saw Cindy Mills Jones. Cindy, how are you, Commissioner?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
Back across the room, I see our Senator, Mr. Murphy.
Good morning to you. I'm Jack Murphy. I'm your Senator from the 27th District. Serving, been down there 12 years, and as Mark had said, we're getting closing in on our last 2 days. Tuesday will be a really late night, and then Thursday on the 40th day, we'll be down there at 12 o'clock at night. So we're going to have 2 days. It's probably 12 days crammed into two. A lot of bills. We've got to go down there Monday and have I serve on rules, and we'll have a rules calendar in the Senate. And I think last time I looked, we probably had about 100 bills on the calendar just in the Senate. And as Mark said, you get down to some of these bills and you start getting into debates at 2 and 3 and 4 hours for one bill. Of course, the opposition, you know, the other party there, the Democratic Party, they know they're going to lose, but they'll get up there and debate a bill anyway so they can get themselves on camera and get their position heard, and that's basically what happens with that. But is there anybody in here that's not running for the Senate? I'd like your vote. There's a lot of things left to do in this town. We need to increase, we need more road funding. We've had $600 million in road funding over the last 10 years, but that's not enough. We need more road funding. And of course, road issues is a big problem up here. We need to look at a lot of other issues. We need to look at 400. We need to constantly see what we're going to do about that. And the governor is on board with doing something with 400. But it's just what and how and where do we get the money? But, you know, that we're aware of that. We want to take care of that. But there's a lot of issues left hanging out there that we need to look at. We need to look at why we're having road funding down in South Georgia and building roads to nowhere, you know.
When we need
the money up here, you know, we've got to have the money up here. And we need to look at our formula and balance our formula and put, if they're not needing the roads in those areas, we need to put the money back into the areas that do need the roads and the ones that's the fastest growing. And I want to look at that and how we can change our formula on the road fund down there. But I would appreciate your support and continued support. But God bless you and your family. Thank you.
I see Representative Duncan.
Good morning, Jeff Duncan, State House Rep for District 76. As the other folks have mentioned, we've got 2 days left in the legislative session. Two very important days. There's a big boy game of chess going on between the House and the Senate right now, and we hope to see that break up. We've got a couple of really strong conservative pieces of legislation that we hope to see come out. We've got a strong Second Amendment support bill that needs to get out and get voted on. We've got HB 707. Some of you have heard about it and read about it. This is the Obamacare Non-Compliance Act. This puts Georgia in a great position to say, look, Washington, if you want Obamacare, then you're going to have to send your assets down here and implement it. But we are not going to use Georgia taxpayer money or resources or departments to implement Obamacare. So we hope to see that come out and vote on Tuesday or Thursday, along with a number of other bills. I've got one that Jack's going to see in the House Rules Committee on Monday at 10:30. And love to see that get through. House Bill 749, the Cargo Theft Act, Georgia's third in the nation in cargo theft. This bill takes organized crime head on, and we're going to put a stop to it and invite businesses to open up shop here and take advantage of those ports when we finally get that port deepened. Take a second to talk about the upcoming election. This is not going to be about my opponent. This is going to be about the folks here in this county. I've been one of the strongest conservative voters down on the House floor and proud of that. But more importantly, it's not enough to just vote no. You've got to have conservative efforts behind the scenes. Conversations and questions in committees, amendments offered to terrible pieces of legislation, and tough conversations with leadership. I look forward to that opportunity for another 2 years and ask for your support. Thank you.
Thanks, Brad. Mike Dudgeon, State Rep, District 25, South Forsyth, a little bit of North Fulton. A couple months ago, I sat in that corner and made a smart-up remark about not wanting the opposition, and I'm very thankful to report that I have the opposition. So I'm very proud to go back for my third term in 2015 and 16. Jeff mentioned one of my favorite bills, 707, on Obamacare noncompliance. We also have 990, which says that the governor cannot expand Medicare without the approval of the legislature. Another great bill. We also did several bills related to different ways to call for Article 5 balanced budget convention, because I believe that if we don't balance the budget at the federal level, we have to do anything possible to force the hand of our friends in Congress to get them to pay attention to this and do it. I'm very excited about that. Anyway, it's my pleasure to serve. I appreciate it. Look forward to another 2 years. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman,
I want to come and see what it looked like when you had a House and a Senate controlled by Republicans. I like what that look is. Truth be told, you know, all they talk about in Washington these days is that they think Georgia is the place where they're going to pick up a Democratic seat in the Senate and a Democratic governorship. And I love the enthusiasm around a primary. But the truth be told, once we find our best and brightest candidates, I'm looking for that opportunity to beat the stew out of them between now and November. Only one or two places in the country that they think is fertile ground, and that's just what you get out of Washington, D.C. You look at Georgia, you think fertile ground for Democrats. We will demonstrate how that is awful judgment coming out of the D.C. Thank you.
It is nice to know Forsyth County can have congressmen, Senate candidates. We attract folks from all over the state. They come here because of you guys, your voting record, the strength and conservatism of Forsyth County's Republican Party. I thank all of you for making that happen. We had one other elected official who wanted to be here this morning. Unfortunately, our sheriff, Dwayne Piper, is in hot pursuit of an armed robber. He called me 5 minutes before I came in here. It's actually fun getting phone calls like that. They are on the main road. There are no citizens or sheriff department employees that have been hurt or harmed in any way. One suspect has been caught. One will be caught soon. Justice in Forsyth County moves swiftly, and we should all be thankful for that. So he wanted to apologize for not being here, but apology is needed. I see a lot of candidates now. We have two that are going to speak here. What's that?
I'm Derek Kindle. I'm representing Doug Collins.
Very good.
Nice to see you, sir. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Anyone want to say anything from the Collins camp?
Sure. Yeah, well, it's a pleasure to be here. Doug's up for his first reelect. The first year in D.C. has been quite interesting. Doug's focus is going to be to get this country back on a path of fiscal sanity. As we travel around the district, the amount of regulations that we see that are really just killing our businesses. You know, government was never meant to set up or never meant to affect business so negatively. I mean, we're supposed to, you know, create an environment where they can thrive. And, you know, like the granite industry, you've got inspectors that come in and actually look for things to find them on the spot. And, you know, those are the kinds of things that Doug's going to continue to fight against. And like I said, just to get this country back to, you know, get Congress back on regular order and get us on a path to where we can eliminate our debt and actually balance our budget. But it's a pleasure to be here. My boss considers it a very deep honor to represent the northern half of Forsyth County.
We're glad to have you. Surprise, surprise, the room is chock full of candidates and candidates representatives, so I'll give you all a minute to stand and say hello. I'll start on the right-hand side of the room, at least my right-hand side, and work my way to the left. I don't want anyone to feel left out. I see the Karen Handel. Mr. Handel's here.
Thank you, Brad. Campaign. Steve Handel, number one supporter of Karen Handel for U.S. There's only one person to beat Michelle Nunn in December, and that's Karen. If you want somebody to go up to D.C. with a proven track record of standing up for your conservative principles, Karen's a person to do it. She demonstrated at Fulton County Commission, taking care of a $100 million spending problem. You know, at the is your first Republican Secretary of State, right? She cut that agency by 20%, improved customer service, took on the Obama administration with photo ID all the way to the Supreme Court, right? We need a photo ID to vote now in Georgia. Little piece of trivia on that lawsuit, Karen actually beat Jason Carver in that lawsuit. He was one of the opposing lawyers. So, silly piece of trivia to stick in your mind for later. You know, so on May 20th, if you want a proven conservative to go up to Washington, you know, help the House and get things done, Karen Handel for U.S. Senate. Thank you.
I see our very own Amanda Nixon. Amanda?
Good morning, everyone. I know most of you, if you don't know me, I'm Amanda Nixon, and I have to say, first of all, before I give my whole spiel about my campaign, I want to tell you that this is actually bittersweet for me. I decided to run for school board, and that meant by virtue of the laws or the rules of the Republican Party that I had to give up my positions with the Republican Party. So I'm no longer the first vice chair, and I want to, is Joel here?
No.
He's not here. I want to congratulate Joel and Carolyn also for their position, newly elected positions. But giving that up and, you know, working through the party and the friendships that I have gained through the party and the relationships that I've gained through the party gave me the strength to do this. And I am running for school board. And several people have asked me why I am running for school board. And it's not about my opponents. Just like you said, Representative Duncan, it's not about that. It's about that I have a child in the school system. It's very important to me. Children are at my number one priority. I'll tell you a story, and several of you have heard this, and I'm sorry if it, you know, I bore you with the story, but I was actually born and raised in Brown, Floyd County, and I had my daughter in Floyd County school system, and I was getting remarried in 2008, and she was in the worst school, probably worst school in the school system in Floyd County, one of the worst in the state. So my husband was from Lilburn, and I was not comfortable raising my child in that school system, and definitely not in Floyd County, and we needed to move because he worked in Alpharetta. And so we started researching, and Alpharetta taxes were way too high for my blood, so I was not comfortable doing that. And so he's like, consider Forsyth County. So I did the research. I visited a couple of schools here. Fell in love with this community, not just the school system, but fell in love with this community. So this is where we moved, and this is where I call home now. So it is about everything with the children. As far as my concerns, I think the Forsyth County School Board has done a beautiful job, an excellent job at everything that they have done for the children in this community and education. I want to enhance that. I want to bring ideas to the table, workforce development, career development, career readiness, all of those things that we really need to emphasize in this community. So that's why I'm running. It's something that I'm very passionate about and you know, really need your support in that. And if you have any questions or anything or concerns, please come to me. It is District 1, which encompasses the Highway 20 area up to, which is the western part of the county, up to 369 in the Matt area. But if there are any questions that you may have or concerns, please come to me. Please talk to me. I do have a website that I'm working on. It's electamandanixon.com, and you will see some information on that soon. So thank you so much.
Working my way this way, I see Ms. Sherry Gilligan, candidate.
Hi, I'm Sherry Gilligan. I am running for the State House of Representatives, hoping to represent you in the 24th District. 24th District is kind of the middle of Forsyth County, all coming. Most of Pete Amos's district in District 1, and most of Todd Levant's current district in District 3. Is that right, the number? I always get the numbers wrong. Okay. But the 24th District, right there in the very heart of Forsyth County. I was born and raised in Forsyth County, so this is my home, this is my roots. But for 21 years, I lived up in the D.C. area, and I learned a lot up in the D.C. area. I did work in the intelligence field up there. Loved what I did, loved my career. But when my husband had the chance to take an early retirement, we jumped, and here we are, back home with my family. I love this community. I am a multi-generational, and I want people who move here to aspire that they will become the multi-generational. That one day their grandchildren who are living here in Forsyth County are bouncing on their knees. They don't have to go somewhere else for that. My special interest group is the citizens of Forsyth County. I was agreeing so heartily with you, Jack, when you were talking about the funding for roads, and we need to change that formula. And we do. We need to change that formula because we should not be a donor county. We should be receiving a lot of that money back because time stuck in traffic is time away from our family, and that's not good for us in Forsyth County. So that's why I want to represent you. It is not about Mark. Mark has represented us very well for 8 years. But I would like to take my ideas down there, take my principles down there, and serve you. If you'll give me your vote, my website is votegilligan.com. Thank you very much.
Okay, working to the left, next candidate I see is Susan Zarini.
Good morning, everyone. I love being here every month. I've met, over the months that I've been campaigning, I've met a lot of friends here, and I've met a lot of new supporters as the time went on. I am Susan Zarini, and I'm running for Solicitor General. What I've asked throughout this entire campaign is for people to make an educated decision at the polls, because so many people don't even know what the solicitor does. And for some of you who don't know, I've had a few people this morning come up and ask me, The Solicitor General prosecutes all the misdemeanors in the county. Your DUIs, your domestic violence, your underage possession of alcohol, any crime that the maximum punishment is a year or less. What I'm asking for is to this be a choice of the people. And when I go out and talk to the citizens, I tell them time and time again, don't vote for me just because you like me or you like my friend. Vote for me because I'm the best candidate. I am the only candidate with the prosecution experience, 13 years, more than double of what my opponents have combined. And this is about a positive thing for this county, about bringing that experience in. And what I ask you again is to make an educated decision at the polls. Please visit my website at zerimiforsolicitor.org so you can make the choice of who you want to represent you. Please, if anyone, I usually am here for the entire meetings. I have a very special supporter who's one of my greatest supporters, although he can't vote yet. My 7-year-old has a soccer game at 10:30, and I must be there. But please, visit my website. I have my email. I promise you, I'll call you back. I love to talk to the people and ask them what their concerns are, and even things about the office of what a solicitor does in more detail. So please feel free, and I promise you, I'll get back to you. Thank you, everybody.
Across the room, I see Jack Schiff. Jack?
Yes, Brad, thank you. Good morning. I'm Jack Schiff. I say that slowly, so if anybody ever says you don't know Jack Schiff, you can say, yeah, I do. He's actually a Republican running for, what's your district, 27? That's right. And everybody who's not voting for me, your primary is on Wednesday. You go to vote on Wednesday. All right? So quickly, I want to say thank you to Jack, to Michael. Is Lauren in here? We've had a chance to actually sit down, all of us individually, and I think all of them individually, which means that we've got kind of a gentleman's race, and I want to thank everybody for that. That doesn't mean that we don't have, as Lauren put it to me, probably the only person to put it to me that way is, you know, politics is a contact sport, but at the end of the day, if you focus on the facts and not on the fiction, those are the things that should be brought to the forefront. So let me just briefly tell you what my background is and why I think I'm the best candidate in the race, although Michael looks much better in a suit. He's taller, thinner, younger, actually has good-looking hair. It's not gray yet. I think for a couple of reasons. One, I've spent 33 years in the business world moving up the ranks and monitoring, measuring, growing employees, and building corporate governance. Corporate governance is key to how companies run their business. The things that are platform specific for me are things like transparency in our government. We need a lot more transparency. I'll tell you that I looked at the budget that was passed for 2014. 239 pages, I think, is the total on the detail, a couple of pages on the front. I then picked up the phone and called a couple of agencies in the last couple of days, and I asked them for their accountable records for the prior year's spend against the budget. Nobody could give that to me. I think that's unfortunate to the citizens of Georgia and the citizens of Forsyth County, because we do a great job as a representative, as a senator, getting that budget passed, but the transparency back to us as citizens is somewhat impossible to get. Now, maybe Mark and Jack can help me figure out somebody I didn't call, but I know I spent hours on the phone yesterday. The second thing that's really important to me, my single most passionate action is around education. I founded a nonprofit here in Forsyth County 3 years ago. This is our third year of giving. We give to academically high-achieving students in high school who have a need to bridge the digital divide, computers and technology, so that they can play on a level playing field with the more affluent students in our community and compete for the best seats in colleges, universities, trade schools, technical schools, or go into the military and achieve a degree there. We have grown by 400% in less than 3 years. We've gifted almost 100 students in Forsyth County, just in three high schools alone. This year we bring on a fourth, next year we'll have all five on board. We think that education and Common Core has absolutely got to be abolished. It starts in the home, it goes to the local people that are responsible to our school board and responsible to our school to manage the curriculum. They are the important people. I don't want them telling me how to manage my company and my job and my employees. I don't think the teachers or even the students want to be told at a national level, behind the curtain, socialists that want to have a common education platform that teaches to the average. We need to continue to gain ground back on our education system. So if you look at our platform, you're going to see transportation is an issue. You're going to see transparency is an issue. You're going to see ethics reform is an issue. You're going to see immigration as an issue. And our top issue is education. So thank you for the time. I don't want to say too much more. I don't want my fellow brethren to have a jump start on what we're going to debate on the 28th, I think. Okay? Good morning.
So Michael Williams, I'm, you know, one of the four running for state senate here in Forsyth County, District 27. I'm not going to take too much of your time. I know we've heard a lot from candidates. Just a little bit myself. I'm a CPA by trade, small business owner. I've actually just moved my brother and his family to this county. We're going to start another business here. I love it. My kids all go to school here. My old son graduated. I've got three others that are in Forsyth County Public Schools. And I just look forward to meet all of you. And thank you for your time.
Yes, I am Megan Biello. Thank you for having me here today. I'm running for the State House seat in District 22, and I previously ran for this seat. There was a special election, and there have been some things that have gone on that I'm still not happy with my representation in the House, so I'm going to run again, and I look forward to meeting all of you. Forsyth County is an important part of this district. The Midway, Brandywine, and Polo areas are the precincts that are in this District 22. And so I look forward to meeting you. I'm gonna continue my door-to-door campaign today. So I'm not gonna stay for the whole meeting because we wanna get out and meet as many people as possible. But my website is bloforstatehouse.com. You can call me, email me anytime. More than happy to talk to you about some of the stuff that's gone on. A little bit about me. I am a teacher in Cherokee County. I taught 1 year here at South Forsyth High School. And just tried to get closer to home. But I know you guys have good things going on here. And Cherokee County, just like Forsyth County, has education at the forefront. Also, transportation is a big issue in Cherokee County as well. So I look forward to working with the local delegation to try and solve some of these problems, funding especially. And also, I have a business degree from UGA. I'm a teacher by choice. I got an economics degree and a political science minor. And I took a year off to kind of decide what I wanted to do. And so I teach because I choose to be there. I teach AP Economics. I've been teaching economics for 8 years. I've also taught government, honors US history, and I love it. I love instilling in this younger generation that it's important that you vote and you get active if you don't like the way things are going. So that's very important to me, and that's part of the reason I'm running, because I don't like what's going on. In my district in particular, and so that's why I'm running. If you have any questions, it's Megan Biello, and I would appreciate your vote on May 20th.
And I know there's a candidate beside Grocer.
That's okay. Good morning, my name is Mark Weiss. I'm running for District 1, School Board Commissioner. The reason I'm running is two reasons. One is my son, he's in fourth grade in Mount Elementary. The second reason is my wife. My son, I watched them for 3 months train our children how to take CRCT. I do not believe in the Common Core, as is said. I talked to the teachers about the math. They say, what math? They don't like it. Our system is not allowing our kids to be educated. They're trying. The second is my wife. Last year, we owed $430 million in SWAT debt. Here's the kicker, 110 of that was interest and fee. It's almost a 39% interest fee. And they're asking for another $195 million? Come on, guys, that's gonna be $500 million in debt. I don't like it, I'm not for bonds. My quote is, bonds are a quick time fix, long-term problem. I want to get our kids off Common Core, that our school systems actually educate our kids. I have 10 years experience on staff of Robert Butterworth, Attorney General, State of Florida. I'm a computer nerd, I design systems. My mom was a teacher for 30 years. I know how the school system works. Sorry, I'm a little nervous. I'm not a political speaker. I'm dyslexic. I saw what school systems do to kids. I don't like it. I want to help our kids. That's why I'm running.
Okay, I believe I can hear.
Pardon me. Yes, indeed.
Right over there, I'm going to ask you, Jack, to point to somebody.
Oh, go ahead.
Todd, you're going to wipe the.
Well, he's a keynote speaker.
Okay.
He and David. Just so everybody understands, normally, most of the year, we don't have quite so many candidates show up. So a little faster. But we do have two keynote speakers tonight, and I apologize to both of you guys, but in a sense, I don't, because we all gather here together to see the best and brightest of the Forsyth County Republican Party, and you're hearing it here today. So I appreciate your patience, and I know both of them are chomping at the bit to talk to you. But Carolyn did want to announce one more candidate, and we'll get more.
Yes, I'm here representing Jack Kingston for the United States Senate, and results really do matter. And Jack has certainly shown that they do, and has saved the United States of America $3.6 billion recently, and he's also cut his office expenses $1.3 million. He has an A-plus rating with the NRA, and one thing that I've known Jack for over 20 years, one thing I really do appreciate about him is that he never, ever wants the American soldier to be in a fair fight. He believes that if the American soldier goes to war, we win, you lose. If you're an American citizen and you get caught overseas somewhere, we're coming to get you, and there will be hell to pay for whoever did harm to you. So I ask for your vote, and we are also having, by the way, a fundraiser on April the 21st. If you're interested in that, you can come and see me or Ethan Underwood about it, and we would really appreciate your vote on May 20th. Thank you.
As I said, today you've heard the best and brightest of Forsyth County Republican Party. You've heard of many of our candidates, many of our elected officials. We do have two that we're going to highlight, though. It's the Commissioner District 3 race. Todd LeVent is our commissioner. David Hull is the challenger. We're going to let David stand up and speak and come on in.
Good morning. My name is David Hull, and I'm running for Commissioner in District 3. First of all, I'd like to thank all y'all for coming out this morning. And thank you, Brad and GOP, for inviting me to be here to speak and let people get to know me a little bit better. I am a newcomer to politics. Also, I'd like to thank my lovely wife of 25 years, Kim, she's here, and my son, DJ, for getting up early and coming out and helping me get started. They're not used to doing things this early in the morning, but I greatly appreciate it. And for almost 22 years, I've had the great pleasure of not just calling Forsyth County my home, but I've had District 3 has been my home for the last 22 years. You know, my wife and I have been lucky enough to have raised our kids in District 3 and had the great privilege of sending them to the great school system that we have in Forsyth County. They've attended all three levels of school, starting out at Midway Elementary, and then graduated from there to Victor Creek Elementary, and then the middle school, and then on to the West Forsyth High School. I can't say enough about our school system. I think it's one of the best in the state. And not only did I get to enjoy the great school system, but the parks and recs that we have in Forsyth County are awesome. We grew up, as probably many of y'all did, we lived at the ballpark. We lived at Midway Ballpark. I coached baseball, football, softball. I didn't coach the cheerleading. Kim left that to Kim, but I coached there for 18 years and loved it. Got to meet a lot of great people and really looked forward to it. My God and family are two most important things in my life. Kim and I, our family, has for many years attended the Brownsbridge Church. We love worshiping there. That's probably enough about me. I get on about my campaign. My campaign is not focused on a burning desire for another title. The titles that drive my choices are the titles I've already earned. I've earned the title of a family man. I've earned the title of a small business owner, successful business owner for 25 years. And also, I earned the title of a servant leader. My campaign is focused on ensuring that not just my kids, but my grandkids and our future generations are given the same opportunity that Kevin and I were given when we moved in for South County nearly 22 years ago. 22 years is a long period of time, and during that time, we had the unique opportunity to witness a lot of changes in Forsyth County, in District 3. We also had to experience an incredible amount of growth in our district. And then there, with that growth, we had some growth was good, and some growth was bad. I'm gonna be working on, your commissioner, on the good growth. With all the growth that comes into our area, we're faced with some numerous challenges, but we're also faced with numerous opportunities as well. The hardworking families of Forsyth County deserve a commissioner who, one, will manage the growth, two, effectively, that's the key word, effectively work with all the others in our county, and also ensure that taxpayers have a voice in their local government, because government does belong to the people. And by that, what I mean is that, you know, as I have already received several phone calls from people, and I've asked to meet with people. I look forward to that. I'm working with the citizens. I take their phone calls and meet with them anytime I can. I listen to their concerns, answer the questions if I can, and give them my opinion if I'm asked. I can tell you one thing I will not do. If I am asked a question, I will not tell John what he wants to hear to answer his question. But that same question that Joe asked me, I'm not gonna tell him what he wants to hear, okay? I'm a straight shooter, I'm a man of integrity. I work with everybody and I'm passionate about that. I'll be an unwavering advocate for the homeowners of Forsyth County. I'm also working to grow our local economy and also hold our elected county officials accountable. I understand that the greatness in our communities comes from the citizens. It does not come from elected officials at all. My experience does not come in politics. I told you, this is my first political race. I'm learning as I go, but experience does come in the form of three things. One, as I said earlier, a small business, a successful business person for 25 years, creating private sector jobs, and also volunteering in our community. I think that's really important to get involved, as I am doing. My service on the Board of Commissioners is not a path to another office, I'll tell you that. I'm just doing my duty. Matter of fact, I'll take a step further. I'll pledge no more than two terms in office. Also have several other pledges I'd like to make. One being to help the local economy to stay strong and vibrant in our district. We also pledge to hold government accountable. Also pledge to eliminate unnecessary spending. Pledge to help the transportation problems that plague our county. We all know, all driving through Forsyth, it's really tough in some areas, especially south end of the county. And lastly, I pledge to work closely with the law enforcement officials and the public safety officials in our county to guarantee the continued safety of the citizens of Forsyth County. You know, we're blessed to live in an awesome county. Forsyth County has so many things about it. Lakeland here, for example, it's an enormous economic engine. It's a tremendous natural resource to our county. We also have the awesome shopping facilities, the fantastic restaurants, the great schools, as I said, and parks and rec. We also have the awesome hospital. We have the Greenway. What a tremendous asset to the county there. I don't use it, but my wife sure does enjoy it. She goes on it every day. It's a great asset to our community. To me, Forsyth County
He's not just a dot on a map or just a blip on the radar, but to me, Forsyth County is my passion, it's my community, and it's a place I love to call home. And I'd just like to thank y'all so much for listening to me this morning, and hope y'all have a good rest of your weekend. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker of the day is Todd Levent. Come on up, Commissioner.
Cold of the season. I beat it all year till now. Yeah, timing's great. Anyways, y'all know who I am. I'm Todd Levent. I am Commissioner of the 3rd District. Originally, when I stepped up to do the job, it was based on nobody knocking on my door and asking me to because they wanted me to do it. I was just watching all the facts and all the things that were going on in the county. It was the downturn of the economy, and I had some free time. As I read some of the paperwork in 09, our budget and the reserve account went from $40 million down to about $13 million. It was concerning to me. It made me dig a little more for facts. I'm not one that likes to listen to folks that say, hey, guess what's going on? I like to dig for the facts, see the real paperwork. Make my decisions on that. As I got into it a little bit deeper, I saw some land purchasing stuff that were really concerning to me. One, I'm not getting the details of it, but it sold to the county for $7.2 million. And today, the research we see wouldn't net us $1.5 million for the same piece of land. These are the kind of wasteful spending things that got me really, really interested in running. But try to put a stop to all, I'm only one voter. I'm not so arrogant to think I could do it by myself. More so, I have been here for 23 years with my family, and I've got to tell you, as I lived in the Sandy Springs area and I watched Highway 400 get built, and I saw the environment we grew up in Sandy Springs, and the growth was coming, I saw Forsyth County as a great place to raise a family, and that was my goal, and that's where we ended up. And it's true, and it's shown to be very true today. So some of the reasons why I'm trying to run again are quite simply because to help secure government transparency, as you've seen in the past, I voted for it. And I believe strongly in the freedom of open records. It helps keep government honest. To continue the quality of life that we've all come to love in this great community of ours. And I know this seems redundant, but it's a fact. This will require reasonable and well thought out growth and architecture. If you've noticed, I got through in my first year, the first overlay in our district, besides the one that was on Castleberry. It goes down all the major arteries and requires a minimum standard architecture, four board fencing, additional plantings. All of this in hopes that we have a little more continuity. If you ever drive on Highway 9, you go, what is going on here with the thought and the process of the future development? So hopefully over the next years, we'll see that change and start to turn into something much nicer, much prettier, and help raise property values around us, which helps all of us, because it also, without raising millage, gets more tax into the general fund and keeps us from ever having to raise taxes on the millage rate. I want you, everybody knows that they've watched the latest reports from the Labor Department. Forsyth County now is at a 5% unemployment rate and it's still going down. So we've had tremendous success in jobs coming into the county. Businesses from coming from all over the state, the country, and even abroad and overseas have come here to run some of their headquarters. I've worked with the chamber on these, I've met with these people as they come in to show interest. I greet them as well as I can, give them much comfort level as I can to bring them here. Although I don't have that much power to do, the chamber's doing a phenomenal job on their own. Anybody would like to see some of my accomplishments, I'm simply bore you to death. They are on my website, toddlevent.commissioner.com. Some of the main reasons why I believe that I need to stay in office one more term is because once you start your first term, you get a lot of things in play, as I just described the overlay. There's other things that I believe in strongly in not wasting our money on certain roads and doing the roads that need to be done first and take them in order of priority. I completely agree with the comments earlier that our gas taxes that are collected that go to the federal government and then come back to the state and then are split congressionally throughout the state is done not by proportionate of the money that's collected, which is a very problematic. I mean, when you're in a community growing as fast as us and we're collecting so much more money than some other communities, we should get back our fair share. It's very problematic when that then puts on the taxpayer, local taxpayers' back through SPLOST and consideration of other bonds because we're not getting our fair share back. It almost seems as if we're paying twice, once in the gas tax and once in additional bonding. I'm not trying to be bashing anybody, just saying you just should get back the fair amount of taxes that you put in the system. Otherwise, you are then giving your tax money to other communities who have taxation without representation. To go down the line a little bit more, those of you who don't know, and you probably do know, any one of these jobs takes a lot more time than you think it does. And I have to thank my family for all the sacrifices they have made. 30, 40 hours a week, sometimes more. I put my children to bed so they can not come up a lot of times at 1, 2 in the morning. If you've ever received an email from me, you'll see the date stamp and time, how late it is at night. And it's just what happens. Some weeks you might get 100 emails, some weeks you get 500 emails. And it's interesting, I have to tell you the least. Although I love every bit of it, I love everything I've been involved in to date. All the classes that we were able to take through the ECCG, through the Georgia University, it gives us government classes, government law classes, to keep you up to date on how and why you vote certain ways and why you have to vote these certain ways. It's awesome that it's available to take. Took them as quick as I could, went through them as quick as I could, just to make sure that the votes I make don't put the county in any liability. But I also got to tell you, we have one of the best darn county attorneys ever. He actually is one of the two that teach in all of these classes, and we're very fortunate to have him here at Gerard. Touching back on some more things, if you all have seen some of these zonings that are coming to fruition now, popping up all over the place and building houses everywhere, almost all of those that are putting cars on the road today were zoned from the year 2000 through 2009. The ones that are coming forward today, I have not voted on a single one as it was submitted. Every single one I've worked with the developers and lowered the density. I'm trying to make more sense than increase the lot size, increase the house size. My biggest one that I got involved in, and I can't do it on my own, obviously the landowner has the rights. They have to give that right to anybody looking to develop it, and then they come to us and ask what works here. Was the Venable property. It turned into what they now call the Traditions, and it's run by Front Door Properties. They came to us, and came to me and said, we don't believe in this economy that's now turning around, that what was originally zoned with over 1.1 million square feet of commercial, which included up to 3-4-story buildings, is gonna work. You've only got 2-lane roads around there, and 900 homes with almost 400 plus townhomes in that community. I agreed with them totally. That was one of the reasons why I ran. There was no plan for any roads to get widened around there anytime soon, and it would have been two times the traffic that the avenues produces, and surrounded by 2-lane roads, it would have been a disaster for everybody that lived there. Fortunately, they worked with us, and we now have 182,000 square feet of village shopping, and we are down to a little over 500 homes, and down to less than 100 townhomes. That's where I've been involved in getting involved in all of the zonings that makes sense for the community. We don't know exactly what the number is. There's a lot of dispute whether a home at 280,000 or 350,000, the exact number that finds a neutral tax collection for the level of services that we provide. But somewhere in there is probably the magic number. And that's not counting the money that comes back to the schools from the state and federal government. Anyways, I don't want to keep going too much and bore you too much. I will continue to work with the state and meet with them on a regular basis, as all commissioners do. We've been doing it 2-3 times a year, in hopes that they're able to find the money to help us with our state roads. Our county roads should not be the primary roads. The state roads should be the primary roads, and we should not widen our back roads into 4- and 5-lane roads before they do theirs first. It's not fair to do that to the residents in the area. Thank you.
April 14th. They're starting it at 6 p.m. You can get there a little bit early and do a little rallying. I believe, anybody here from the Tea Parties? Who's the primary speaker?
For Swamp?
No, for the tax day rally.
There's a number of, I'm not with that one, sorry.
The keynote speaker.
I know that Tom Price.
Tom Price.
Yeah, Congressman Price.
That was it, that was the name I was looking for. As I keep saying, Forsyth County is attracting great people. And so when we have congressmen and senators and elected officials of that level wanting to come here and talk to you guys, it's because of what, not only the Tea Party does, but it's because of what the GOP does. We drive the Republican message, the conservative message. Folks know Forsyth County is a conservative county, and we attract speakers of this magnitude who want to come and talk to us about taxes, even though I forgot who it was. Thank you, Sherry. Yes, ma'am.
The rally will be in front of the courthouse.
That's right.
In case of bad weather, we'll go to the fairgrounds.
That's right. It's at the courthouse. In case of bad weather, it'll be at the fairgrounds. So mark your calendars for that. That's coming up. I've been asked by many people about the debate schedule. We're still nailing down a couple of details on that. When there's so many races, it's a little more challenging than you may think. Does everybody here know the Forsyth County GOP website? Raise your hand if you don't know where our website is. Okay, keep looking. Look there every day, really. I mean, I'm not asking too much. Go there every day and look. But really, by Monday, we should have it posted. So go Monday. Who here is not getting our emails in our email blast every month? You can admit it. I won't spam you. Okay. We'll also get an email blast out for announcements. That way, I'm not going to keep you guys here all morning for announcements. I think, oh, yes, ma'am.
Well, if you have Gmail and you get your GOP email in your Gmail box, check under promotions and then add us, because when it goes to Gmail, if you don't know to look under promotions, then it's constant contact. By the way, if you haven't met Carla, she's the new corresponding secretary. Carla Radzikinis. Awesome.
Sherry's place.
Yes, thank you. but check there, because even what you'll get from your representative, your congressman, if you don't know to look in promotions, you don't know what's going on from your representative. So always check there if you have Gmail.
Good tip. Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, I would like to let the people know that this coming Wednesday there's going to be a prayer and rally at the state capitol. Basically, we're praying to get our religious freedoms restored and a lot of other things that didn't take place at the Capitol. At 11 to 12, we'll have a lot of keynote prayer pastors on board, and then the rally will be from 12 to 1:30. And we would love as many as possible to come out and pray and be a part of this function.
11 to 1:30.
Wednesday.
At the Capitol.
Yes.
Prayer for our state. And for religious freedom.
Yes.
That's actually very important. If you can go, mark your calendar. I know downtown's a bit of a haul. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to announce that the video from this morning will be on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/Nydia Tisdale.
Very good.
Thank you.
We're glad to have the video. All right, everybody, we're going to adjourn, but you don't need to run off. You can mingle. There's still a little time. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Baylor's in the scrimmage today, and then team pictures.
I'm good one-on-one. I'm good on one-on-one, but when I get in the front,
I'm also not. I'm also not. Yeah. Right. Okay. Have a good day.
Good to see you.